brawled with Natalia, Carmella, and Tamina backstage. And now, we're seeing Becky Lynch versus Carmella. He's lucky he doesn't have to feel the wrath of the daredevil in my alter ego. He's called the Monster of the Ring for a reason. Not even 3 minutes, 2 minutes, 57 seconds. How pathetic.
Hopefully, we will hear an explanation from Sammy. cigarettes may leave you with stained teeth, gum disease, and more.
Hey, Bob! Bob!
Got a text? I found it in your locker.
Cubs. I'm delicate.
Thank you.
because on Sunday night, you almost lost me, too. Because at one point during the match, I saw it. I was blinded by that white light you hear so much about. And I felt my soul start to separate from my body.
What the hell is this douche talking about?
It was such a bizarre feeling. It was like I was floating outside of my body, looking down at myself. And then all of a sudden, here I was standing in a long, long line at the pearly gates. And you know, I don't like standing in line very much, so I was pretty aggravated as I'm standing there trying to figure out a way to cut in front of everybody. I was waved to the front by St. Peter himself.
What the hell is he talking about?
I stood there. St. Peter looked at me and said, Kevin, as much as we would all love to have you up here, they need you down on Earth. They need Kevin Owens. And he even provided me with my very own guardian angel, Sami Zayn. And then as I returned down and re-entered my body, that's when I realized my new purpose. And that's to turn SmackDown Live into my very own personal paradise. And here we are, all gathered here tonight in Kevin's Heaven, or as I like to call it, the Kevin Owens Show. So without further ado, let me introduce to you my best friend and guardian angel, Sami Zayn.
Together in heaven, Sami Zayn, the guardian angel, grinning ear to ear. Very nice to hear the destination.
Before you start, I'm sorry to interrupt you, but before you start, I think you need to explain to everybody that I had no idea you're going to come out on Sunday night and Hell in a Cell, that I had no idea you were going to do that, and that I had no idea why you chose to pull me away from certain destruction. You need to explain that to these people, but before you do so, I need to tell you from the bottom of my heart, Sami, thank you.
Listen, and I'll explain everything, but it's funny that you're thanking me, because actually, you powerbombing me on the apron a few weeks ago is what started opening my eyes to everything. You see, my whole life has been spent trying to please people. My whole career has been about pleasing all these people. No, and I tried to be the good guy and do everything the right way and put all your hopes and dreams Meanwhile, Kevin Owens, my counterpart, became the Intercontinental Champion. He became the Universal Champion. He became the United States Champion. But that's okay because I get to sleep at night. Yeah, I get to sleep at night with a clear conscience. And if I keep doing things the right way, maybe in 4 or 5 years, my time will come. And I genuinely thought that my time had come when Shane McMahon invited me, gave me the opportunity to come to the land of opportunity, SmackDown Live. Oh, and did he put on a show for me. He told me everything that I wanted to hear about how Raw had been mistreating me and misusing me, which was true, mind you. But how SmackDown Live would give me the opportunity and the respect that I deserve. Well, that was the last meeting I ever had with Shane McMahon. But it's okay, you know how people get busy and birthdays and you have that whole helicopter thing. And, you know, it's fine, I get it. I'll just keep coming every week with a smile on my face. And I did that week in and week out until a couple of weeks ago. When I saw Shane McMahon in the hallway and I tried to warn him about what Kevin Owens is capable of. And I think we all saw what Kevin Owens is capable of at Hell in a Cell. Yeah. I tried to warn him and he said, he brushed me off. He brushed me off. He ignored me. He said, Sammy, you know, don't worry about you and don't worry about me. And that's really when I realized Shane McMahon never cared about me. He never really cared about me. He never really wanted me to get an opportunity. So cut to Hell in a Cell. Shane McMahon versus Kevin Owens inside the Hell in a Cell. I'm watching the match with bated breath just like every one of you. And honest to goodness, just like every one of you, I wanted Shane McMahon to win. I did. And when Shane McMahon knocked Kevin Owens off the Hell in a Cell structure to the announce table below, he had that match won. I'm sorry, but he had you beat. But then he turned around and he started to climb all the way back up to the top of the cell. Now, let me tell you something. Kevin Owens has been a lot of things to me over the years. He's been my best friend. He's been my bitter rival. He's been everything in between. But the one